Good morning. And Stephanie and I wanted to really grab your attention with this title. But more than just attention grabbing, this really is our vision, and we really believe that it is achievable. And I'm going to talk today about how we're proceeding towards that vision. We do know it's going to take a huge amount of time, effort, and money to get there, a real investment. And we know we're going to have to adopt and change new ways of working. But change and modernisation just isn't an option. We have to go forward. Staying still is just to go backwards. And it's essential if we're going to survive in these more difficult times. Certainly there's a spiral with membership. You know, if you get more, become more efficient, you're going to do more work, you're going to gain more members. The more members you have, the more income you're going to get. That means you're going to do more work. The more members you have, the more influence that you can do when you're lobbying national and local government. The more lobbying we're doing, we're seen as more indispensable, so even more people want to join us. So this great big cycle about how to achieve it. During the session, I'm going to just talk about a few of the trustees' strategic priorities that come under our remit as Marketing, Membership and Communications Directorate, which also incorporates IT. We're going to talk about the current plans that we're doing towards that vision, that tripling of membership. And then I'll be handing over to Stephanie, who's going to do a current membership review and talk about how you can help us at the very local level. So the first strategic priority we're working towards is putting in place an IT system to meet our business needs. We have a big cycle of benefits I was just talking about started off with being more efficient so we can do more work, more bang for our buck. Our systems have grown up over very piecemeal over the last 20 years. We've got an absolute mishmash of hardware and software, databases that aren't talking to each other, no integration, lots of duplication. In fact, what's surprising at all is that we can do any work at all given these massive Heath Robinson systems that have grown up around us. And I know you get frustrated by some of our inefficiencies because I've seen your complaints that are, when they're related to IT, as they often are. We've got this wonderful new building. When I look at the slum, I think, oh, we could never have started to move forward and move our IT systems forward. But with this wonderful new building, we've built an IT platform that we can really move forward on, the absolute foundations. And what we're doing for trustees is putting together a feasibility study of exactly what a new system is going to cost, this full integration that we need to be able to meet our business objectives and to reach that vision. What it's going to cost us and what the payback period is going to be, sort of cost-benefit analysis. We're not doing that alone. We are working with consultants who are going to come in, look at where the business wants to be in 5 years' time, what kind of design do our systems look like to get there, and then we'll be working very hard and moving forward. Just while I'm talking about IT, I'd just like to give a plug. This is the first year ever we're going to be, election of trustees is going to be an online vote as well as the normal way. I encourage you to vote electronically if you can, it'll save us money. If we've got your email address and all the right data protection statements, we'll be emailing you to say vote online and directing you there. If you don't receive that email, please do, if you want to, vote online and opt in to the right data protection statement so that we can contact you that way in the future. The second trustee strategic priority is to reduce membership lapsing. You all know we enrol many, many members in every month, and equally lots and lots of members are going out the door. Stephanie and her department do lots and lots of work, cajoling, begging, letters, phone calls to members to keep begging them to come back. But ultimately, it's only a great product and a great service that we give that people simply can't live without, which is going to stem the tide. We must become a much more desirable organisation. And I think the consultants that we worked with last year on the branding recently told us that 50% of people who join the National Trust never go to a National Trust property. They just desire the car sticker and that, showing they're a member. So we want to be like that, a desirable organisation. Last year we focused on updating our tired image. That was effectively dressing the window, encouraging, trying to get people to take a look inside our shop and what we do. this year we're taking a long, hard look at the product that we're trying to entice people to buy. And relating to that is the third trustee priority, working hard, is continued development of our work on marketing and customer segmentation. Last year we recognised that people have a journey, you're passionate about horses, you build this journey with horses. Starting right from when you're very young, 3 or 4 years old, you might have had your first interest in horses. Later on you'll go on to ride horses, maybe own horses, maybe compete with those horses, or work in the industry. Later in life you might want to have children and want to share your passion, and children become passionate about horses alongside you. Then later in life you might stop no longer ride, but you're still really, really enthusiastic about horses. What we're doing at the moment is trying to match the BHS journey much more closely with that journey. That means getting a package for children. The owners and the riders, the professional package, and an enthusiast's package. Our first step to get there is good quality market research, and that's what we're working on right now. The second part will be to plan these packages, these five new membership packages, and to launch them. And we'll be providing a business case to the trustees for doing that. All this work goes very much hand in hand with the IT work. They're very closely aligned. But they certainly make for really, really exciting times ahead. And I'll now hand over to Stephanie, who's going to talk a bit more about the current membership.
We've had a very productive couple of years in this tough economic climate. What's been positive about the BHS is that actually we've continued to grow. So in 2009 we grew by 1.9% and last year by 2.6%, which is fantastic when, as I said, the current climate that we're in, but also we know that other membership organisations, they're actually falling. So we're really, really pleased with this. However, as Emma said, we are also lapsing at an incredibly high rate, 20% at the moment. From previous research, we believe that this is a number of things. One is that people don't truly know what the BHS are doing. We're hard work. The message isn't as widely spread as we want it to be. We know an awful lot of people are joining as gold members. 98% of our membership base of 73,000 are gold members. And they're telling us they're joining predominantly for the insurance at the moment. So when they then aren't riding, or they believe to have found a different insurance quote or more cost effective, they're then leaving. We need to stop that. Another one is students. We have an awful lot of people that have to be a member to take an exam. Again, they're not seeing the true value of the BHS and all the work we do, so when the exam's done, they leave us. All of these things, and more that will come out of the research that Emma has mentioned, needs to help us change. In advance our product and our service offering to stop that lapsing rate being so high. So therefore, obviously, we've got an awful lot of people coming in, but an awful lot of people going out. So the actual growth over a total year is fairly minimal at the moment. We're always working hard to try and increase our service offering and our benefits. One of the really key things that we've talked about for an awful long time and actually was made live last year was becoming paperless with direct debit. So people can now phone up and pay for their membership fees, direct debit over the phone, and we'll be moving forward to make that live on the internet and reviewing other ways moving forward to again increase our offering. So the future of membership. We know that there are about 4.3 million riders in the UK, and when we look at that target segmentation that Emma just referred to in terms of the enthusiasts, the riders, the owners, we think that this is a fair number that we believe that we should be targeting and can get into the BHS as members. So at the moment, with us having 73,000 members, that's just 1.7% market share. It's a huge opportunity to change. And as Emma said earlier at the beginning of this presentation, we want to at least triple that membership and should be more than achievable. How do we get there? Well, firstly, I think everyone needs to work together. We need your help. From head office here, we're constantly thinking of ways to reach those people, tell them the message, but we can't do it alone. Hopefully with your help locally, you can help spread the message and the good work of the BHS. taking more action. We talk a lot about what we could do, let's start to do it. Increased communication, wider presence nationally and, as I said, locally. So we are always looking at, you know, advertising, how we get that message out there in the different communication channels, but you helping spread the word locally will truly make a difference. On the back of the research that we will be doing, we're going to obviously try and enhance our offering. Once we find out what it is that people want from us, we're going to make some changes and make sure that those benefits and packages suit our target audiences to hopefully reduce that lapsing and increase more people coming through the door. As I said, we're always looking at ways to improve the administration of the membership, so it's easy payment mechanisms, easy forms of just staying with us through their journey and their life cycle. Things like monthly direct debit, quarterly direct debit, internet banking, all those sorts of things to make it easier. One thing we're looking at this year is also having an area specifically for members online as well, so that they've got extra content, benefits, and ways of administrating their membership. And promote the work we do is absolutely essential. People do not realise everything that we're doing. And at the moment, we find it hard to create that empathy, that connection with people. You know, other charities like the RSPCA, Bernardo's, anyone like that, they've got a very good way of communicating and pulling on the heartstrings. You know, poor little Flossie, we found her on the side of the road, she was abandoned, we've rescued her, look how happy she is now. We need to do more of that. And that's local case studies from you and what's happening in your area and spreading the message. So what can you do? Very recently, at the beginning of the year, we just sent a survey out to all our membership secretaries and said, you know, what are you doing in your area? What's finding is working for you? How are you getting members involved? And here's just a few of what came back. So welcome letters with a survey to members. So every month when we let you know who's joined, you're reaching out to them, welcoming them to the area and letting them know what's going on, but also asking them what they'd like to see. Newsletters, so ongoing communication, encouraging them, informing them, all the time spreading the word of the BHS. Placing dispensers at yards, colleges, tack shops, anywhere that you think a dispenser could go to, again, let them know about the BHS and the membership would be really helpful. You know, I know that you're all extremely busy, most of you are still working or you've got other things that take up the majority of your time. But things like within your committee, if one of you, or every one of you, could at least once a month or once every other month place a dispenser, if that's all you did, just think of all the people that you might reach across the year by picking up a leaflet. Word of mouth. So again, any opportunity, friends, you know, you go to a dinner party, you might meet someone, it's an opportunity to talk about the BHS, what you're doing, and the good work we do. Raising awareness, public relations, you might have contacts with magazines and newspapers that might be able to again start to spread the word of the BHS. Gathering emails saves costs and helps us communicate more effectively. We're never going to be able to become completely paperless. We realise that there are thousands and thousands of people that don't want to use the computer, but equally there's an awful lot of people that do, so we have to embrace that as well. And obviously, by us gathering emails and getting the right data protection statements, we can communicate more effectively and quicker. And again, things like Facebook, local websites, all the time thinking of ways to promote the BHS. And I know some of you are a little bit like, oh, Facebook, but we have to, again, embrace that. That's what a lot of our target audience wants to see. What's available to help you do this? Well, at the moment we've got posters that talk about the membership and the BHS, we've got dispensers, application forms, car stickers, event posters for any shows or that friends might be going to. Again, we've got the membership data with the correct data protection statements for you to reach out to members, talk to them, inform them what's going on locally in your area. And then also if you are, you have contacts with your newspapers or anyone else, then we've got text, we've got everything to support you to do that. And all those materials are actually situated in the bookshop, which is next door. So please do help yourself to those things. Share them with your committee if there's any way that you think you can promote BHS membership. So together, we can triple membership. Thank you very much.